German-Korean project
artistic activity and to facilitate critical reflection both bilaterally, which is Germany, Korea, or multilaterally, which other European countries, or even between. Finally, a project that we did with some fellow panelists, a contribution as part of the organization to German-Korean project.
Welcome to this radio picnic with the artist Ralf Homann. This is part of our, believe it or not, film and video program for this year's Transmediale, which has been curated by Florian Wüst, hiding in the shadows there, soon stepping in here, I hope. In the spirit of Transmediale conversation piece, the program is has also mutated out of the theater sal, the cinema space, into a series of hybrid events happening here in the exhibition hall. Some screenings too, but every day we've also had these hybrid cinema events. And today we have Radio Picknick, as already mentioned, which intertwines the history of pirate radio with the history of the picnic. And what that all means, I'm sure that Ralf himself will take you on a journey too, and I would like to leave over the microphone to you, Florian, and please welcome Florian and Ralf.
Thanks a lot, Christopher, and you stole some of my line in good old pirate manner, so I can make it a little shorter and just start directly introduce to you Ralf Homann, who's an artist and author who regularly produces radio features, for instance, for Bayerische Rundfunk in Munich. And his work deals with the interrelation between space and electronic media, and he is interested in the narratives underlying knowledge. From 1999 to 2008, he developed the experimental radio department at Bauhaus University in Weimar. In more or less the same period, he formed together with Manuela Unverdorben and Farida Heuk the Bundesverband Schleppen und Schleusen, Schleuser.net, an art project that mimicked a lobby organization for business enterprises, specializing in undocumented cross-border passenger traffic. Currently, Ralf and Manuela Unverdorben work and exhibit together as the Better Think Tank Project, BTTP. What makes today's radio picnic unique is the fact that Ralf and I chose several historical short films to be shown during the performance. And that also justifies it to be part of the film and video program, or that attempt to create a more hybrid situation as well for the film and video program as part of Transmediale conversation piece. For me personally, as the film and video curator, that was a really exciting endeavor to do. So during the performance, you will see a Siemens commercial, Farbige Klänge, Colorful Sounds, from 1953, produced by Studio Fischer Kösen, which was the most important or biggest animation film studio in the early years of West Germany, producing numerous commercials and industrial films. Here I want to thank Nathalie Schütze for English translation and Silix for making the subtitles both very last minute. Then we'll see excerpts from a film by Ricky Calve, Hexenschuss, in English Interferences, from 1978. And we will see Äther flitzen. The English title is Radio Europe, by Hans Richter from 1931, produced for Philips. And Let Our Voices Be Heard Too, a film documentary by Krsto Papić from Yugoslavia, 1971. He's a very, as part also of the new Yugoslav cinema or the so-called Black Wave. Croatian-born Krsto Papić was an important filmmaker and documentary filmmaker at that time. And this is about Yugoslav or Croatian pirate radio stations in the countryside. But now I'm really happy to welcome Ralf. The picnic is yours.
So thank you for tuning in and thank you for coming to the radio picnic. This is the site of the picnic. There are some items that are typical for picnics. For example, the blanket, the basket, the picnic basket. And I think the blanket is the most important thing for a picnic because I can move around a blanket, a picnic blanket. I have access from all sides, from this side or from the other side. I can do it clockwise, for example. So maybe this is a 6 o'clock point. 6, 9 o'clock. So I can record my seat in a way in a broadcast clock. So broadcast clock means this is 6. This is 7, so the basket marks the 7, 8. This is 9, and 9. This is 3. Yeah, it's 3, and this is 5 minutes after 3. So it's time for a jingle. So the jingle was 3, some minutes after 3. One jingle, the other one. And the third one. The fourth one.
You like this? Who is this? Who is this?
Tesla time machine.
So there are some items which are important for the micro radio, for example, antennas, the transmitters, and finger food, also very important. Here's some celery sesame, for example. Give it to the role. And a script. A script is also very important for radio because this is not a DJ show. Back to the blanket. The blanket of a picnic gives you a kind of an orientation. So you are on the blanket, you are nearby the blanket, so you are part of the picnic. But you can also take a leaf. You can go some meters away, and you are still part of the picnic. Similarly to the radio, the antenna gives you a kind of an orientation. And of course, you can leave the range, the energy field. Then you can go back to the energy field. But also when you are not tuned in, you leave the program, set off the radio, you are still in the radio party because you know that there is a transmission. There's always this energy field. The picnic space is omnidirectional. I mentioned that the blanket has access from all sides. And the picnic site is not a question of imagination, it's not a question of visuals, it's more a feeling. You feel that you are in the picnic, part of the party. Even though radio has no images, or radio has images. If I say each radio has images, I do not mind the idea of radio is a cinema of your mind, your imagination. But each program has visuals, images, for example, I see the red basket, the green blanket, the black chair. And like the picnic blanket creates an omnidirectional space, the radio antenna creates an omnidirectional space. Please play in the movie.
Sinnreichen Maschinen und Vorrichtungen fertigen einzelne Bauelemente. Kondensatoren, Röhren, Spulen und so weiter. Hunderte solcher Teile gehören zu einem Rundfunkgerät. Aber erst das Können erfahrener Ingenieure schafft aus den einzelnen Teilen die technische Qualität des Empfängers. Muss nicht nur technisch vollkommen sein, es muss sich auch in seinem Äußeren harmonisch und frei von modischen Effekten in jedes Heim einfügen. Wir stellen vor, Siemens Spezialsuper. Siemens Qualitätssuper. Siemens Großsuper. Siemens Phono Super. Siemens Spitzen Super. Alle UKW perfekt und störstrahlungssicher. Ihr Rundfunkhändler zeigt Ihnen gern die Siemens Qualitätsserie 1953.
So, this hall is a kind of a cinema. This hall has a hierarchy. There's the entrance, there is the main screen we will not use during the picnic. There is a direction, like in theatrical stage, 19th century, end of 19th century. And the space of radio is completely different. There is no hierarchy. There is no back and front. Listening to radio or listening in radio, you can walk around, you can turn around. The screen gives an orientation, but also it's an adjustment for your body and also for your mind. Radio is a kind of non-orientation for your body and for your mind. So play into the film, please.
Too long. Let me speak.
Mach doch nur eine kleine Pause. Oh, Luzi, endlich, Mensch. Ist doch schon alles vorbereitet. Die Antenne ist oben. Mhm.
Ist schwer.
Ja.
Oh ja. Ja, passt. Mhm. Na, gefällt's euch?
Darum geht es jetzt mal.
Grüß dich.
Oh. Ne? Doch. Ja. Toll.
Funktioniert. Prima.
Komm, Luzi. Warte. Ach ja, der ist drauf. Mach euch auf.
Gehen Sie ins Zimmer und Tür zu. Ja. Ja, was gibt's? Ja, jetzt hör zu. Das worauf ich.
So, just a clip taken out of Ricky Kalber's Interferences, Florian mentioned before. The film tells the story of three women who live together and build a jamming transmitter, a TV transmitter, which they use to hijack TV news. It's a film from 1978. Some years earlier, in 1975, the anti-nuclear power movement in Germany had reached its first peak. The nuclear building site at Wiel, that's in the southwest of Germany, the site was squatted. It was the beginning of a lot of temporary squats which accompany the anti-nuclear power movement in Germany. Temporary squats, camps, and so on and so on. And this resistance against the nuclear power plants in southwest Germany, but also in the triangle to France and Switzerland, this resistance was accompanied and supported by pirate radios during the camps, during the squattings. One outcome of that supporting by pirate radios was, or is, Radio Dreieckland, the first so-called free radios in Germany. Here are some items from Germany's pirate radio history. For example, this nice transmitter, Swiss made, is from the Switzerland group against the nuclear power plant in that triangle I mentioned, between southwest Germany, France, and Switzerland. It's from the Zurich group. It's really nice made. I can switch the frequency here, inside. And I can boost that up to 50 kilometers. And this antenna was used by Radio Frei in Erfurt in the late 80s. It's a typical GDR communist antenna because they used your brass to repair the antenna. Brass is more expensive than aluminum, but it was available in the GDR, easier than aluminum. The GDR antenna and the Swiss-made transmitter fits really good together. But the office of the chancellor is too nearby. Okay, this is poor political poetry. It's a kind of a leaflet lyricism. It's from a pirate radio up in the north in Germany, in the harbor of Hamburg, the 80s. And it sounds more like radio telephonic traffic. And of course, since the spark turned to an MC, radio has become a dancing medium. The world is a beat, not a leaflet. There are some theories on the question when radio starts. And one is the story about the battleship Ohio, USS Ohio, in the early 20th century. When the spark started to broadcast dance music from the Ohio, there was the concert, to the other battleships. Before, radios was a military technology. It was radio telephonic traffic. And after this first concert, dance music concert, the radio as we know it started. But like always, also Radio Hafenstraße with all the noise and distortion activates a space that is simultaneously public and private. And one that affects the space without changing it. What remains is the listener's experience that lingers on. The same is true for the picnic. The picnic activates any space. This space is also simultaneously public and private. It affects the space without changing it. What remains is the party's experience that lingers on. And by the way, you can revisit a picnic place or meet again years later. A picnic place is a kind of a secret address, coordinates without tracking. Radio has also a mystery. Nobody knows what you are listening in, much less who is listening. It's just radio, not wireless. And that's really important for some radio station. Stations with antennas hidden deep down in the countryside, hidden high up on trees, or even somewhere far out on a remote moor or on the shore of a river. So play in the slide, please. Edouard Manet, Oil on Canvas, one of the most well-known displays of a picnic, Déjeuner sur l'herbe, 1863. In this painting, Edouard Manet refers to a disegno by Raphael. The Renaissance painter created the disegno for a judgment of Paris, the Trojan War, and the end of the ancient world. And Manet painted this kind, this picnic scene also to mark the end of an ancient world, the Ancien Régime. In this picnic painting, some items are missing. We know from Karl Marx, at the same time, Karl Marx's family preferred during their Sunday picnics escargots or shrimps I see here only fruits, and I'm really missing the red wine. Here I have a bottle of red wine, French one. Maybe this here. That could be an empty bottle of schnapps, but there is no red wine. Red wine is important because it's a typical French beverage. And the picnic is probably a French invention. There are two versions of the history of the picnic. The one version is the French version, and the other one is the English one. The French version pinpointed the provenance of the picnic in France, and the English version declares the origin in England. That's the European story. Probably there are other ones. For France, the picnic was a revolutionary act during the revolution in the end of the 18th century. When the people squatted the nobles' gardens. The citizens had been squatting the royal parks. They had opened their doors for a new enfranchised or liberated future. Some historians, who sided more on the aristocrats, reported on vandalism, for example, in the Tuileries Gardens. However, from the revolutionary viewpoint, that kind of squatting was seen as a pleasurable political method for changing the royal ground into a public one, a policy of appropriation to turn a place into a space, to turn a private noble property into a public one, to transfer it into the realm of the commons by means of contemporary face-to-face meeting, face-to-face, it's very important. Back to the 9 o'clock position. And also by means of a very close and broad communication, like in Manet's painting. By contrast, the English version illustrates the picnic, the origin of the picnic, in a shooting, an outcome of a shoot, of a noble hunting trip to kill animals. Play in the film, please.
Nach dem traditionellen Signal der Begrüßung, die gut gemeinte Jagdbelehrung, möglichst keinen Treiber anzuschießen. Zu den wenigen, die nicht mit der Doppelflinte in den Wald ausschwärmten, gehörte Gastgeber Gustav Heinemann. Neben Hasen war heute alles freigegeben, was der Jagdschein erlaubt. Kaninchen, Fasane, Füchse und Tauben. Als die 50 Treiber mit Knüppeln und Geschrei durch das Unterholz brachen, brauchten die Jäger nur anzulegen. Trotzdem kam mehr als ein Hase durch. Zufriedenheit herrschte dennoch über die beachtliche Strecke. Mittags wurde gemeinsam im Wald gegessen. Bundespräsident Heinemann hatte neben den Diplomaten auch die
Selbst einen Hauch von Sünde kann Weiden aufweisen. Drei Striptease-Etablissements sollen von diplomatischen Repräsentanten ab und an frequentiert werden. Neben dem persönlichen Service
im Kanzleramt. Ulrich Wegner, der Chef der GSG-9-Truppe und seine 61 Männer, die in Mogadischu dabei waren, wurden heute von Innenminister Mayhofer mit dem Bundesverdienstkreuz ausgezeichnet.
Wir haben den Krieg nicht erfunden. Wir sind nicht gewalttätig, wir sind aggressiv und zärtlich. Wir schließen nicht zu, wir sperren nicht ein. Wir öffnen alles, was ihr zumacht. Wir leben, weil ihr endgültig gestorben seid.
Another clip taken out of Ricky Kalbe's film Interferences. Kalbe's film is partly a polemic montage of archival TV footage, which shows how men in leadership positions talk about women and what they do. Here you've seen two interventions in the German news show, the woman with the poodle and the voiceover in the white noise. It's a copier. I have a cheaper one. Bonsoir. Please, the slide. Yeah. Max Radler, der Radiohörer. It's from 1930. I have wine in my picnic basket, but I have no hunting things, no dead animals. Karl Marx had dead animals during his picnics in London. That's right. Roasted veal, very cheap. There is no halloo in our picnics. There is no halloo, no death halloo, no blood. So that's one reason why I believe really that the French version is the right one and not the English one. But the other point is, in the English version, there is no changing, no transformation of the space. When the nobles eat outdoors after hunting, they are still on their manor. They are the owner of the ground. So there is no change of the space. The French version gives the space a changing from a private property to a common one, depending on common laws, depending on jedermanns Recht. Probably that's one reason why in our times a lot of people believe in the English version. It seems that the idea of no movement, of immobility, no transfer of spaces, that this idea is so overwhelming. It seems to be reassuring and comforting to be in a line of tradition with one's ancestors. The idea to have horses, dogs, and a good old property which will naturally remain. This radio listener is listening to Radio Moscow. Though I refuse the English version of a picnic, I like this antenna from UK. It's a good antenna for switching the frequencies. So it's fine for all radio stations who are not interested in frequency branding, just for radio surfing. He is a radio surfer. In those times, the classical liberals were fighting against public services. Their mastermind, Friedrich von Hayek, had the idea to say, we must destroy all these public services. But it was really hard to destroy the unions or the British Health Service. So the Liberal Vice President of the Liberal Party, Oliver Smedley, created the idea to destroy first the BBC. It's easier. And to create a model how to transfer the commons, how to transfer a common good like the airwaves into a private one. And so Smedley contracted pirates against the BBC. The battle cry, Hayek's battle cry, von Hayek's battle cry was the BBC monopoly. But de facto, the airwaves in Britain were full, were really full of radio stations. It was a worldwide network, a worldwide wireless network of AM, HF, and long wave. Please play in the film.
British Broadcasting Company, London calling. Good morning, everybody. Are you ready? One, two. One, two. One, two. One, two.
Un, deux. Un, deux. Un, deux, trois.
Uno, due. Uno, due.
Et, two.
Bourse, marché calme, pétrole stable, cuivre et fer en baisse.
Industrie, flow, koninklijke petroleum, kalm, tabak levendig.
Eia, Radio Roma Napoli, vi comunichiamo i dati meteorologici. Cielo sereno.
Aquí Radio Madrid, Barcelona. El tiempo está esplendido.
Weather report. Sunshine all over England. Even Scotland.
Thank you.
nous avons gagné. Elle servira dans notre ménage l'argent que nous avons gagné. Elle servira à nous marier.
Evening news.
Corriere della Sera. Corriere della Sera.
All the way down.
All the way.
Evening Standard.
I don't think anything of Einstein's theory because I can't understand it.
Heeres namenloser Techniker, welche die Instrumente des Radioverkehrs so vereinfachten und der Massenfabrikation anpassten,
we're leaving the ship that made it before this, going through the canal, when we were in the Renown.
Allô, allô, ici Radio Toulouse, nouvelle sportive.
Café.
Sport bulletin.
Training for Wimbledon. Schmering, go on, Maxi. Drawing match between Oxford and Cambridge.
Dames en heren, we brengen u de sportberichten.
Deportes.
Ici Bruxelles, émission d'essai. Vous entendrez maintenant la musique de danse du restaurant Chantilly en vert.
London calling. Jack Hilton broadcasting from the Kit Kat restaurant. London calling. We are closing down until tomorrow. Good night, everybody. Good night.
Thank you.
The worldwide network of AM, HF and long waves. The airwaves full of stations, Radio Luxembourg, for example, broadcast the Stones and the Beatles to England. Radio Bero Münster from Switzerland was really important during the war and after the war. But instead of that fact, the battle cry, the liberal classical liberal battle cry was, there is a monopoly. And this battle cry got on heavy rotation in UK. It was resampled also on the continent, in Italy, in Germany. And at the moment, again in Switzerland, where the followers at the moment are fighting against the public service, the public radio in Switzerland. It's just a myth. It's the English version of pirate radio. It's the English radio version. It's similar to the English Picknick version. Cuius regio ius radio. That's a Latin phrase which literally means whose realm his radio. This means that the radio approved of by the ruler was to dictate the radio to be used by those ruled. A little weird, because radio is aired, not earthed. And I can listen to radio independently of the real estate of where I am at or in or on. So let's come back now to the uncertain ground of a picnic, back from scratch. The space is just temporarily occupied. Its quality is unclear. When the blanket is away, the picnic is away from keyboard. I don't know. It's either a public space like a park or a common land or a private property under common law of every man's right, like in a wood, maybe some offshore custom law. In any case, a picnic can never claim a discrete private property. It always applies to the idea of the commons. It's part of a community. Play in the film, please.
Dragi slušatelji, moja radiostanica Kutnjak priredila je za vas naše mužikaše Habeke za vaše i moje zadovoljstvo. Želimo vam dobar prijem uz dobru kapljicu domaćega vinčeka.
Small. Dragi slušalci, dobar dan. Ovdje je radio stanica Cerija na srednjem valu u 249 metara i 1204 kHz. Započinjemo naš današnji program. Želimo vam dobar prijem i ugodnu zabavu. Dragi slušalci, javljamo se prvi puta sa malo boljom kvalitetom i snagom, zahvaljujući našem upornom istraživačkom radu. Naš studio je u mogućnosti da svakog dana emitira program sve jače i jače, kao i kvalitetnije. Dragi slušalci, mi ćemo i nadalje raditi na usavršavanju našeg studija.
Ja sam bio jako zainteresiran za to kako to, na primjer, jedan radioaparat može svirati i šta je to u njemu i to. Onda sam ja, baš zbog toga što sam bio jako zainteresiran za to, počeo sam se onda baviti s tim i to mi je svakog dana sve više postao neki hobi, kojeg, na primjer, sad u današnjih, mislim danas, ne bi mogao živjeti bez tog hobija. Tako imam, recimo, jaki hobi za to. Ja ne bi dao ovo za nikakve pare, pa niti za ništa na svijetu. Ovo stvar, mislim, tu radio stanicu i jer ja imam toliko osjećanja prema tome. Mislim, ja sam željan toga i ja sam zadovoljan kad ljudi mogu čuti preko ovoga brda još dalje mene.
Ja sam stigel ovdje u svoju radio stanicu jer imam na srcu tešku ranicu. Moram dobar biti, sam svoje glave sve zvoditi i pred mikrofon iti, sve mora dobro žiti jer ja moram sve na pamet govoriti. Ja se ne trebam nigdje ništa počiti, to samo mora kaj poluju iti. Držim vice, ima svaku vrstne žice. Od Zagreba grada do moje radio stanice sada žica ne može postojati. Ja se neću nikoga bojati.
A sada će nas susjed Ignac za radio stanicu Kućan i slušalce radio stanice Kućan otpevati nešto iz svog repertoara. Izvolite.
Sutra da mir tek pjesma tvoja umorno šapće molitu. Večernji zvonovi lagano biju i zove s nam slatki san i zove s nam slatki san.
Posjednici privatnih divljih radiostanica u stvari vrše štetnu djelatnost jer rade neorganizirano i nekontrolirano, a čim neka osoba može preko svoje radiostanice emitirati sve što želi, onda to može biti i opasno u određenim momentima. Osim toga, sve divlje radiostanice smetaju radu domaćim i stranim radiostanicama koje normalno emitiraju svoj službeni program.
Dragi slušalci, lokalna radiostanica Donje Ladanje nastavlja svoj program našom redovitom emisijom Wir sprechen Sie Deutsch za naše ljude koje namjeravaju otići na rad u Njemačku. Bitte eine Suppe und Brot. To znači molim jednu juhu i kruh. Bitte eine Wurst. To znači molim jedne kobasice. Bitte eine Bier. To znači molim jedno pivo. A sada nastavljamo s govornim dijelom njemačkog jezika iz naše prošle emisije.
Was kaufte Lotte? Dienstag und Mittwoch sind vorbei. Heute ist schon Donnerstag. Noch Freitag und Samstag und die Schüler machen den Ausflug.
Radio stanica Štijev. Štijev daje svoj redoviti pregled politike, privrede i kulture. Zadnje vrijeme, upravo dragi slušatelji, mi smo nekakvi frapirani s
tim raznim dogodovštinama kaj se v svijetu sve događa. Prvo broj jedan, rat v Indokini, drugo rat na Bliskom istoku, posjet predsjednika Sjedinjenih država našoj zemlji.
Mi se moraju, kako se veli, svoje državljane zvati, a svaki se k Titi navrati, jer Tito mora sretan biti po svotu, Titi svakemu prijateljstvu biti. I tako je moglo iz Amerike pismo iti da ide i predsjednik Nixon drugo Titi, da se mora u Beogradu ziti i Kumrovec su morali iti, lepo ga je domaša piti, za stolom biti, zdravice piti, a ja nisam mogel poleg biti sretni, ni mogel, može biti, zato sve skupa lepo pozdravljam i ovo za
A sad da se osvrnemo malo i na domaće probleme, a to je zaposlenje naših ljudi pri nama, tu v našoj zemlji, a i vam nje.
Mi moramo zajedno na poslu biti, svoje činiti i svoje ćemo dobiti. Plaća se mora povisiti, plaća mora dobra biti i dobro dati, mi moramo doma na poslu stati. A ne mehančari se zvati, ja ću tam pare brati, na auto se pelati. Mehančar moram biti, na svojem se voziti, malo se napiti, stegno otiti, glavu razbiti, onda ma ne vredno Nemačko iti, bolje doma ostati, bar se more živ zvati, živ ili drugovi.
Kaj sam još htjel reći? To je prilično težak položaj našega seljaka.
A mi se moramo radnici zvati svaki svoju komandu znati, a ne se drugom zafrkavati dati. To se odmah znalo da svi hoću drugovi biti, a mi hoćemo tako govoriti. Da svaki mora svoj gazda biti, a ne da dirigiraju svi koji nas gledaju, da svoju komandu nad nama držio.
Sve o svemu, njihova djelatnost je štetna, društveno, politički, moralno i materijalno.
Dragi slušatelji, još bih htjel neke reći ovoga puta, kad smo već rekli da bude to udrobljeno koje čega, o seljaku i kulturi. Mi na selu razonode kulturne ili nekakvog posebnog uzdizanja nemamo.
Najplaš kao sunce, ko tebe čovjek nigda nema mira, ni doma, ni u gorica, ni na drumu. Ajda, mila, ajda, mila, hajde, hajde. Kome, kove kleti,
ne se kleti. Kovi, i to je, bodo ljudi počeli obloke opirati, ne bom znala kam bi od srama gledila.
Hej vi tamo, zaustavite krave.
Jer sam ti rekla nečko miš.
A što je to?
Milicajic. Jer si se tak napil, kad ni čovjeka ne poznaš. Stani, krave!
Hej! Hej! Oha!
Zašto nemate svjetlo na kolima?
Svjetlo? A kako svjetlo?
Noću kola moraju biti osvjetljena. Odnaprijed treba imati bijelo svjetlo, a od traga crveno. Jedno i drugo treba postaviti s lijeve strane kola. A gdje vam je registarska tablica?
A kaj je to?
Registarska tablica?
Zato nikda nisam ni čula. Eli to mora biti, a kaj je to?
Oznaka čija su kola. Ovdje treba biti s lijeve strane.
A pak se mi u selu s njim dobro poznamo i kaj će nam tablica?
Mene cura moli da spavamo goli, a ja neću, bojim se umreću. Ojebem ti takvu sreću kad ja više fučkat neću, tako, tako, pa tako, alaj biti.
Ovdje je radio stanica Lopatinec. Dragi slušalci, uključujemo se u direktan prijenos iz koncertne dvorane naše škole, odakle vršimo prijenos koncerta Tamburaškog orkestra škole. Dirigent Novosel Ivan.
Dobar večer, Mario. Malo sam zakasnio. Nemoj se ljutiti. Šta je? Šta šutiš?
Čekam te već više od 15 minuta. Šta misliš, da sam ja lutka s kojom se možeš poigravati?
Nepravedna si prema meni. Zakasnio sam jer sam bio na partijskom sastanku.
Otkad si ti Darko partijac?
Od danas, od malo prije. Upravo dolazim sa sastanka mjesne organizacije Saveza komunista. Primili su me za člana.
Oh, Bože.
Šta je? Zar te to ne veseli?
Ni najmanje.
A ja se vidiš, ti me ponosim. Mogu li čuti razlog tvog negodovanja?
Ti dobro znaš mog tatu. Kad to čuje, više mi neće dozvoliti da s tobom hodam.
Ne vidim prepreke našoj vezi.
Ja tatu znam u dušu.
Moramo nastojati da ga ubijedimo da nije u pravu. Pravi komunisti su dobri ljudi. Oni koji ne valjaju prije ili kasnije će morati otpasti.
Sve o svemu, njihova djelatnost je štetna, kako politički, društveno, moralno i materijalno. Za efikasno suzbijanje rada divljih radiostanica neophodna je suradnja između SUP-a te svih društveno-političkih organizacija i ustanova.
Moja radio stanica više ne radi. Od nedelje. Od nedelju tu radio stanicu su mi oduzeli već po šesti puta. Ja ne znam koga to može smetati, zašto ja govorim iz svoje kuće, pa zašto se moj glas ne bi čuo i dalje, a ne samo u kući. Ja ću i dalje nastaviti sa time jer imam veliki hobi i veliku želju za to. I ne mogu mi uzeti ono što znam, recimo pamet mi ne mogu uzeti jer se s tim bavim i znam o tome.
Pozdravljam vas iz jednoga maloga mjesta, to nam reke s kojega. Sad nije važno, ali... Prav je reke župnik pišta, da je čovjek sve to ništa. Kad život obiće konac, trpat će te vraku lonac. Loncu vrak će da te kuha, da bo s tebe vragom juha. Amen.
Evo sada ja opet nastavljam svoje programe. Držim vice, prazne su mesnice, treba špeka, narod čeka, narod je živ, nije kriv.
From those omnidirectional landscapes back to the contemporary visual arts. When cinema was invented, one of the most influential German sculptors was Adolf von Hildebrandt. He worked a lot in the public space, he was specialized for public space and on theory. And his theory is still now very influential. He came to the conclusion that the best sculpture should be flat. There is no such thing as speciality. Each three-dimensional work has just one point, one ideal position to be perceived, and it's the place we nowadays call the camera setup. Adolf von Hildebrandt's ideal was the bas relief. That was a great idea because his sculptures could be really televised. Then again, the space is always a place that moves on. And please, keep in mind behind a bas relief or beyond a painting, there is nothing. After the radio, there is always a sonic blink. Probably sometimes just a taped whispering. So thank you for tuning in.